Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It is Monday, November 18th, and I am just making myself some breakfast today, and I wanted to show you what it is. I am making my pumpkin oatmeal. It is so good, and so I'm not gonna show you the entire recipe as I make it because I've shown my oatmeal a million times, and it's honestly the same exact thing. I do my oatmeal, I do one serving of oats, so a half a cup, which is about 45 grams of oatmeal, and then I just have it in here. And I always add, I think it's 2 tablespoons. Yeah, 2 tablespoons of my flax and chia blend. I get this from Vitamin Shoppe. It has a bunch of fiber in it, healthy fats, and it really makes the consistency of the oatmeal so good. And I am just boiling some water on my stove with a cap full of pure vanilla extract and a ton of pumpkin pie spice. And so I'm just going to, as I talk to you, stir in my oatmeal. And what is different about my pumpkin oatmeal is that after about 5 minutes of me cooking my oats, I add in 1/4 cup of pumpkin puree, just pure pumpkin from the can. And I just stir that in with some almond milk. Hold on, sorry, let me stir this up. That flax and chia blend, you really have to stir. And then I'm just gonna turn down the heat a little bit because it's super boiling. And I let that go. Just, I don't put a timer on, honestly. I just wait till like the water is a little bit more absorbed. It really takes no time at all to cook these old fashioned rolled oats. And right now I'm using this toasted oats and almond butter, but I use so many different types of nut butters. I have flax milk, I have toasted coconut almond butter, but I thought this oat, the toasted oats, would be good in my pumpkin oatmeal. And then just to tell you what I do, I'll show you what the oatmeal looks like when I'm about to eat it. But after, I stir protein powder in, vegan protein powder, and then I drizzle some pumpkin spice vegan eggnog. I drizzle that over the oatmeal. And for the first time, today is the first time I'm gonna be trying this. I got this from my grocery store. Pumpkin seed butter. It's green, so it's gonna look really weird, but pumpkin seed butter. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna try that. Usually I use walnut butter, but I saw this at the grocery store and I'm like, okay, it's seasonal, I have to try this. So I am right now, let me just show you what the oatmeal looks like. It's getting thick. So right now I'm gonna add about 1/2 cup of almond milk, my protein, and the pumpkin. So I'm gonna go because this is burning. I'm gonna play some Christmas music and I will see you when my oatmeal is done. Bye. Yummy, yummy, yummy. This is like super not Instagram worthy because of the green butter. But oh my gosh, it's actually really good. I like the pumpkin seed butter. I add stevia to my oats, which I didn't mention, but again, if you've watched any of my vlogs, you know my oatmeal base, it never changes. And then this is the yellow stuff, is that eggnog, the pumpkin spice eggnog. Always put pink Himalayan salt on my oatmeal, always. I actually am gonna bring the salt over here just so when I get to like the middle and the end of the oatmeal, I can even add more salt. I love the salt flavor. And then just more pumpkin pie spice. And then I posted this on my Instagram, but in case you didn't see it, a grande blonde Americano with steamed almond milk, 1 pump of sugar-free mocha, and 1/2 pump of peppermint. Whew, so good. So I'm gonna enjoy this. I'm gonna enjoy my oatmeal. It is 60 degrees here in Florida, so I am all holiday Christmased out. And I am listening to Christmas music on Pandora, so I'm gonna play this and enjoy my oatmeal. I will see you guys in a little bit. Like this video if you always leave a little bit of nut butter on the very last bite. So, so good. So I had to get back on here before I'm even finished with my oatmeal because one, I have to tell you that I just now have perfected these pumpkin oats. So when I've made them before, I've been eating pumpkin oats or trying to make pumpkin oats for the past couple days now. And I was finding that it wasn't really tasting like pumpkin. I'm like, where is the freaking pumpkin flavor?
And so today I added the differences. I did vanilla extract in the water while it was boiling before I even added the oats. So I had the vanilla extract, which was new, and I added a ton of pumpkin pie spice to the water as well before I even added the oats. So the water that is soaking up the oats, that is being flavored before I even add the oatmeal. So when the oats are cooking, it's cooking in this really flavorful, pumpkin-y, warm liquid, which was key. And so that was the difference. And then I think the difference was I really truly used so much more pumpkin pie spice and so much more cinnamon. So just start slow, I guess, with the seasonings until, because I like my stuff very flavorful. But if you wanted to make pumpkin pie oatmeal, really go absolutely ham with the pumpkin pie spice. And then another thing I did differently is I used chocolate protein this time. And for the past couple days, I've been using vanilla because I was nervous that the chocolate flavor would kind of mask the pumpkin. But I actually like this better. I like the chocolatey pumpkin. So just play around with it. But I just wanted to let you guys know what I did differently to really make it pumpkin-y, because I was finding that I was like, what the heck? It's not even pumpkin. But the pumpkin spice nog, that eggnog that I added to the oatmeal, that little drizzle, that's a must. That is absolutely phenomenal. And that really tastes pumpkin-y. So, and then one other little thing before I'm still eating, but before I go and finish this last delicious bite, is I want you guys to think about how fast you eat. Like really, like how fast are you eating? And what distractions are around you when you are eating? So are you sitting at your desk at work while you eat lunch, and before you know it, your lunch is done and you didn't even taste it? Or are you scrolling on Instagram or using your phone? Are you watching TV, watching YouTube? Are you on your computer? Is there any distractions? I used to watch YouTube on my phone while I ate, and I found that like my food was done and I'm like, oh, I don't even remember tasting it. What the heck? And so I was like, you know what, Christina, if you love food so much, why aren't you tasting it? Why aren't you taking your time? I'm a very fast eater. Like, I'm acting like there's a famine going on. Like, why am I eating so fast? And so I have to actively, every day, this is still a practice that I have to do every day, I have to sit down with present awareness that I am going to take my time with my food. I'm gonna put my fork down and I sit next to my window and I just kind of like taste my food. I'm just super present. And I find, and I drink water a ton in between my bites. And I find that just by slowing down and being present and drinking water and having sips of my coffee, that when I'm done with my meal, I'm so much more full and satisfied, and I'm not getting up like, oh my God, I want more oatmeal, because my oatmeal is like a dessert. It's so good. And there's so many times where I'm finishing my oatmeal and I'm like, oh my God, I want another bowl. And I think that's the problem with most people. They think that they have this extreme hunger, but it's just because you're eating so fast and you're not giving your body enough time to send the signals to the brain. Oh, yep, I'm full. It takes 20 minutes for your brain to get those signals from your digestive tract that, oh, all right, yep, we got enough food, we are full here. So if you're watching this, obviously you're watching this video. Well, today, since you're watching this video, I just want you to go in each meal with a little bit more presence, more mindfulness, and go slow, drink water, and take away all distractions. So I'm gonna finish this and then I'm gonna go for a walk because it is 60 degrees. It's so nice out and I need to just like suck up all this weather. I'm so grateful for it. Then I am going to film a meal prep and grocery how-to for my website. And just, I want to show you how truly easy it is. And I'm also going to be teaching you ways to easily create meals, because I know for everybody that follows me, their biggest block is, I don't know what to make, I don't know what to make. And I have such a simple answer to that question. So if you are subscribed to my Health is Easy membership community on my website, you're gonna get this video. It's gonna be in the motivational tab. It's gonna be priceless. You're gonna love it. And if you are interested in being a part of the community, I highly recommend it. It's basically like having a coach because there's workouts, there's recipes, and then there's education, like what I just explained I was gonna be uploading. You can just click the link below in the description box and sign up. So I will check back in a little bit later. I'll probably show you maybe my lunch, maybe my dinner, I don't know, but yeah. Oh, and I'm making homemade hummus, but I've never made it before. I'm doing a roasted pumpkin or a smoky pumpkin hummus. So I'm not going to record me making it because I just want to perfect the recipe before I share it. But if it's good, it'll be on my subscription site, homemade pumpkin hummus. Ooh, I'm so excited. So, all right, I'm gonna stop talking. I'm gonna finish this wonderful bite. I'm gonna go back to playing my Christmas music and I'll see you guys a little bit later. All right, it is lunch time and I'm so excited to show you my Buddha bowl. So this is basically, I think, what vegans do, just eat bowls of random stuff and it tastes amazing. So let me go through everything that's on this, in this bowl, because it's a big one. I'm so excited for this. Okay, so on camera this looks terrible, but oh my god, I'm so excited. So this is some marinated tempeh. So freaking good. Let me know if you want the recipe, because wow, it's really good. And then I have quinoa under here. You can't see it, but it's a nice big serving of quinoa. I have some homemade pumpkin hummus. I have roasted parsnips and carrots, roasted Brussels sprouts, roasted acorn squash with roasted pumpkin seeds on top. And then I drizzled over some of my homemade tahini dressing. Wow, I need to eat this. I'm so hungry. My mouth is actually watering. Let me know if you want me to give you the recipe for the tempeh. I'm not sure how many vegans or plant-based people follow me, or if you're interested in tempeh, but please, if you can, comment below and I would love to give you this recipe. So I'm gonna eat this, then I have to run to Target really quick because I'm making Brian. Wait, let me look at you. There we go, that's better. I'm making Brian a vegan apple pie cheesecake. It's a cheesecake, like a vanilla cheesecake with a graham cracker crust, and then topped with like an apple pie crumble brown sugar pecan topping for his work party on Thursday. And then I'm being interviewed for a podcast. So I need to get going. But let me just try this tempeh. It's so yummy and I'm shocked at how much I love it. I need a fork. And I'm also, ooh, I forgot to tell you, beets. I add beets to everything. Got beets in there. That bowl is filled with vegan protein, healthy fats, healthy carbs. I'm taking a digestive enzyme. Let me just go through with you what is the fat and the carb and the protein. So we have carbs from the quinoa, protein from the quinoa, the tempeh. So I don't know what happened to the sound quality, but it totally sucked. So I'm just going to speak over this short little clip. So what I was telling you here about the tempeh was that for 3 ounces, it was 8 grams of fat, 8 carbs, and 18 grams of protein. So this was a very well-balanced protein option for me to give me healthy fat, carbs, and a good amount of protein for a 3 ounce serving. And I definitely had more than 3 ounces here. Acorn squash, it's low in carbs, but it technically is a carb source, but it's low. I wouldn't even count it as a carb. The beets are a carb. The Brussels sprouts are a carb. The parsnips and the carrots are a carb. The hummus is a carb. The tahini dressing is made with tahini, which is a fat, a very healthy fat. And it's also, I have a tablespoon of maple syrup in there. And then roasted pumpkin seeds for some more fat. So I just want to go through all of that with you. And then, oh, and the pumpkin seeds are protein as well. And then this is my digestive enzyme. I just started taking this brand and I actually really love it, but I gotta go eat. Love that.
Dinner time.
She's the best, guys. Come look at what we got.
What are we eating?
We are eating curry.
We're eating a vegetable and lentil curry, and I just made white rice in the Instant Pot, and I seasoned it with some lemon or lime juice, cilantro, and a little bit of the lime rind. And then for Brian's curry, I added some Japanese sweet potato, because he loves the potato. And then for me, I have bell pepper, eggplant, and broccoli with a little bit of rice and some avocado, because I have eaten so many carbs today. I shouldn't even be eating the rice. I don't want to say I shouldn't, no, but like, should. I need more fat. So I'm like, I need avocado, but look at how good this looks. So this is mine. I have more veggies, but the carbs, yes, the white rice looks like I don't have a lot, but this is a lentil curry, so the whole entire thing is a carb. It's really good though. And then Brian has like a restaurant quality looking. Look at your meal.
I know. It's
are you dead right now? This is a paratha that we got at the farmer's market. Mine was filled with pumpkin, his is filled with potato and lentil, and he's gonna eat it kind of like a pita with the curry. And then I gave you some avocado, I didn't know if you wanted it.
I did.
So we are gonna eat. Are you excited?
I can't wait.
Yummy. So we just finished dinner, I cleaned up the kitchen. Brian's cuddling with Miss Luna, you can hardly see her, she's so dark. And I look like a boy, but I'm about to wash my face, so my hair's in a bun. But I wanted to close out this video. I'm sorry this video was so random. 2 days of a day in the life, I guess, slash showing you my meals. I just basically showed you my breakfast, lunch, and dinner from 2 days. But I didn't show you any of my snacks because they're honestly so random and I didn't just pick up the camera for it. So eventually I will do a full day of eating, but I wanted to close out this video just with a quick update on how we're feeling being vegan. I'm gonna speak, actually you speak for you first. How are you feeling? You started vegan, I don't even know how to say it, started veganism, started eating vegan a week before me. So it's like, what, a month for you?
Over a month. This is week number 5 for me.
So how do you feel?
And I feel great. To be honest, I felt more of a difference earlier on when I first made the change.
But I have to say, which I think that he doesn't really realize, is when you do something consistently, that's your new normal. So you can't feel better and better and better if you're doing the same thing.
Exactly.
So of course you're.
But I'm having great workouts, I'm having great night's sleep, I'm having a ton of energy each day.
So you like it?
Yes.
Are you missing meat?
No, not at all. Not with you cooking.
He has though. There's been instances, this channel is about honesty, so.
I miss like my,
I'm not gonna lie.
I miss my bad food that I used to eat, like Chick-fil-A and things like that. But I don't miss like, I'm not missing like.
He's never like, I want a.
I don't feel.
You have not even said like, I want a steak.
Not at all. I don't need that at all. Like,
yeah. He just misses
fully satisfied.
The fast food stuff. But when he does have those cravings, he just goes to Burger King and gets the Impossible Burger, which apparently I haven't had it, but apparently it tastes exactly
like a Whopper. It tastes just like a Whopper.
It smells just like
just
a Whopper.
Just like a Whopper.
I'm gonna have to get it someday.
And you can ask them to cook it on a separate griddle so it doesn't touch the same skillet that the meat does if you care about it to that degree.
Which we don't.
I do not at all.
We don't care. I'm not even gonna do that. We're not gonna touch base on that.
Keep your fans.
But yeah, right. But and then Brian, which I think is a great tip for men, he loves Morningstar like breaded chicken patties. He got corn dogs, mini corn dogs.
Oh, those are so good.
He gets these meat lover pizzas. I have a pepperoni hot pocket in the freezer for him.
And the ingredients are real things, you know? It's stuff it's like, you can pronounce. Like, sure, some stuff is maybe like hydrolyzed or stuff
but
like
even
that,
like,
but nothing crazy at all.
But even our vegan butter, our vegan cream cheese, our vegan feta, all of that is, if you look at the ingredients, the first ingredient is coconut oil. Like, it's really actually like not shit.
Yeah, or water.
Right, like we look for the good stuff. And then that is Brian. For me, I have not craved fast food at all, which I mean, I don't eat it, so I guess I never craved fast food before. I guess not fast food for me, like that's normal. I haven't craved like our favorite burger.
Mm-mm.
Isn't that crazy?
I've been loving every time I've had a burger being vegan. Yeah. I love the Beyond patties.
Yeah, we like the Beyond patties. I did some research if you guys are wondering about, like, if you guys want to switch to this way of eating or introduce more. I read and did some research that the Beyond Burger's ingredients are better than the Impossible Burger. Mm-hmm. I've never had the Impossible Burger. I've only had a Beyond Burger, which I made at home only one time. So I've only had a burger once.
And the Meat Farm Co. ones you got were good too.
I didn't have those, but he had those. Mm-hmm. Meat Farm Co. Mm-hmm. He likes those. We got those at Whole Foods. But I'm really experimenting with this tempeh. I love the tempeh. I'm gonna buy more and make that. I haven't made tofu yet, so I'm gonna experiment with different things of tofu. And there's an ingredient for Kentucky Fried Chicken tenders.
Ooh.
Using jackfruit.
Oh yeah. And I found a vegan like mock Chick-fil-A sandwich that's Ooh. Chicken satin. I just haven't made it yet, but I want to try it really bad.
Oh, cool.
I knew this one's helped though.
Okay, we'll experiment with that. So yeah, that is our update. I am loving it. I haven't had any cravings. I actually crave, I wasn't ever a big craver, I guess. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm very satisfied with my meals, but I feel like I crave sweets less. He doesn't, but I do.
We're not lying. You got me ice cream 2 days ago and I haven't tried it yet.
Yeah, but if I got you cookies or something that you could just eat, like, stop it. I'm not even gonna go there. But I feel great, so. But I will say, if I was trying to lose weight, I wouldn't do vegan. I wouldn't do it just to lose weight. That's what I'm gonna say. I wouldn't going vegan as like a reason to lose weight, because I'm eating so many more calories, so many more carbs. I'm still trying to keep the fat up there. It's my struggle. I love carbs. And that's just what I go to. So it's like a conscious effort to eat fat, but we are loving it. I'm gonna go. This video, I'm sure, is super long. So thank you guys so much for watching. Comment below, please, if you would like the tempeh recipe. Once again, I have no idea how many vegans watch my channel, or if you're not vegan and just want to incorporate more plant-based protein, just comment below and I will gladly post it for you. And I will see you in the next vlog. My mom is coming here for Thanksgiving, just to give you guys an update. And okay, we're gonna go. I'm gonna wash my face. It's about to be
bedtime
bedtime
later, guys,
which is 8:45 p.m. Bye.